Welcome, everyone, to this 2K Sports broadcast live from downtown Minneapolis. We've got an action-packed Saturday night of NBA action for you. Thanks for joining us. This is Kevin Harlan with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg and our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. Look at New Orleans winning their last three games. They'd like to make that four in a row here tonight.
And they've battled these guys to one win and one loss. It's been really an intriguing matchup. I'm looking forward to seeing how the third chapter plays out.
Likewise, I mean, they've got no choice but to go for broke here, let it all hang out, both of these teams. I mean, they know each other really well over the first two meetings, and it's led to a bit of animosity between them. At least that's how I'm reading it, so it should be one heck of a ball game here.
And with tip-off coming up, we've got just enough time to hear from our good friend David Aldridge on the sideline. D.A., take it away.
Well, guys, Karl-Anthony Towns has a different disposition than his predecessor and mentor, Kevin Garnett. But KG said of Cat, don't take the smile for weakness. He plays with another type of engine. What they do share, Kevin, is a true love for the game. Back to you.
Outstanding, D.A., thank you. And at this point of the season, Clark, we can see which teams have the better depth, the better bench. If you would, talk about the importance of having a strong bench over the long haul.
For contending teams, I think it's a difference maker because it allows you to work through the length of the season in a more measured way, which gives your key players rest. You spread out the minutes over more players, so that tends to lend itself to freshness as you get ready for the playoffs. I don't know if you can overstate the value of a quality bench when you're a team that's expected to make a deep run in the playoffs.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's check out who's on the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. So for New Orleans right now, Payton and Holiday are together in the backcourt. Down low, it's Randall and Davis. And it's Moore in at the small forward position. And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves getting the first points of the ballgame. Pass to Davis. Oh, good on that one. Towns with the defensive effort. And so it's Teague with it. He'll bring it up for the Minnesota Timberwolves. Okogie, the jumper from the free throw line is good. We're about 1 minute into the first. Here's Holiday, and that one hits back iron.
That's a good shot. Even though it couldn't find the bottom of the bucket, I like the shot quality.
Wiggins finds Teague. Davis against Towns. Six on the shot clock. Shot from 12, and stolen by Payton. No good from Moore. And Antoine Moore has always been a solid shooter in the NBA, Greg, and he's continued to grow in that department.
I mean, just look at the career numbers from deep in terms of efficiency. And the last few years, he started to take on more and more volume in terms of the three-point shot. Hasn't changed his percentages, though, at all. And I would give him the green light as much as he wants from beyond.
The first one falls. That one falls, so he hits both of them. And so just over a minute and a half played. Outside Holiday, the pass to Payton. He kicks to Randall. Payton looking around. Just five to shoot. Over T. No good from Payton. The Timberwolves with a quick start to this game. Wiggins passes to Teague. To the left wing. Here's Towns. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague. Towns has got his first 2 points of the night.
Oh, fruitful possession. Just doing what they can to extend the lead.
Yeah, that's tremendous efficiency there. I mean, you like seeing them put together these types of plays.
Now here is Holiday. Coming off a solid outing against Cleveland, Randle with the bucket.
That's a nice move by Randle. That's the area where he likes to work most.
T kicks to Wiggins. We've got 1:13 left to play here in the first. Teague bounce pass. Okogie. That one misses. And New Orleans will go the other way with it. Loads it up for Davis. Deft touch on the alley-oop.
And that log came from a mile away, and it was right on the money.
Talk about a long-distance connection.
I want to talk about those incredibly soft suction cup hands there, not only to make the catch, but to lay it in, too.
And he's just a tough defender. Good positioning to get after that shot.
Did a good job guarding the mid-range, extended out nicely, and definitely bothered the shot.
Now here's Davis. A 38-point game for him in the win against Cleveland.
And don't forget about the four blocks. Just a big all-around game, particularly on the defensive side.
And the Timberwolves with possession here. Following the three-point attempt by Anthony Davis. Three-second difference between shot clock and game clock. It's stolen by Davis. Payton outside. With 4 seconds on the clock. And it's Davis missing.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over him.
And we've reached the end of the first quarter. Minnesota on top, up by 4. And we'll be back with you right after this. One of the most high-powered scorers in the game, Karl-Anthony Towns, knows it's important to keep his teammates involved.
You know, everyone has to get some of the sugar, you know, so making sure you're not just being a ball hog. So I'm just always trying to make sure that I'm taking wide open shots that I think everyone on the team would love for me to take if I have the opportunity. But also at the end of the day, making sure everyone gets a chance to be in the candy shop.
Well, when you're attracting, Greg, all that defensive attention, it creates opportunities for your teammates.
And Towns wants to win big. To do that, though, it's not enough to get numbers. You've got to make your teammates better as well.
And for those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. And before we move on, what do you guys think about what we've seen so far from the Timberwolves?
Just playing suffocating defense. That's been the difference here for them.
You know, Greg, I love watching this team get after it on defense. I mean, they play with a bit of edge and nastiness.
They've got Gorgui Dieng. Wiggins is out there with Dario Saric. Then there's Derrick Rose. And it's Bayless in at the two. That's the five to begin the second quarter for the Timberwolves. Here's Clark. Holiday, left side. Lock at six. New Orleans needs to get off a shot. Miritich's shot is off. Timberwolves leading by 6. Outside Rose. Kicks to Bayless. Pass to Wiggins. The Timberwolves need to get a shot off here. The shot by Saric, no good. And so Holiday will bring it up for the New Orleans Pelicans. Their last encounter was in New Orleans.
You're going to win a lot of games when you can shoot the three ball the way they did in that one.
And you know, you see teams relying on the three ball more and more nowadays. It's a big part of the game, and they made it rain out there in a big way.
Now here's Bayless. Over Miritich. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. Bayless has got the lead up to 8 now for Minnesota. Clark, you once worked for the Indiana Pacers, vice president of player relations, and really had your fingerprints on a lot of part of that organization. Could you see yourself going back to an NBA front office role?
I don't anticipate that. I love what I do as a broadcaster. I really feel as though I'm right where God wants me to be currently. Had a wonderful tenure with the Pacers, 32 years between playing, broadcasting both radio and television, and then 4 years in the VP of player relations role. Phenomenal relationships with a number of people, but no, I think that chapter for me is in the rearview mirror.
I speak for everyone playing the game, watching the game. We're glad you're in broadcasting, I'll tell you that.
Thank you, partner.
And again, New Orleans has no luck. Minnesota leading by 8. To the middle. The shot by Saric, no good.
Well, at best, the defense was average. I mean, he must make sure to finish these layups. Got to make those.
And stolen by Jang. There's 49 seconds left to play in the first half. Rose gets to Šarić. The Timberwolves working the ball around now. Back to Rose. On the wing, Wiggins. The Timberwolves, again, can't hit.
That's a look you cannot pass up. It's also one you shouldn't miss.
Left side, Šarić. Passes it to Jang, and there's a whistle. That goes on Ian Clark. That is his first foul of the game. Two seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Jones kicks to Towns. Four on the shot clock. And Davis sends it back.
Boy, I tell you what, Davis uses his length so well. I mean, a defensive stalwart who holds his ground, and because of his timing and length and athleticism, he's an excellent shot blocker.
And so it's the Minnesota Timberwolves holding on to an 8-point lead heading into the break. They've been playing some ferocious defense. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thank you. Jeff, you guys had a great first half. Is the key to the second half to continue to be that aggressive?
Yeah, we got to play defense. They're a really good team. They're going to play hard. They're real physical. We just got to come out and keep guarding.
Jeff, thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hi again, everyone. I'm Ernie Johnson, sitting alongside the Diesel and the Jet. Welcome to the Halftime Show on 2K Sports. It was a fast pace for Minnesota at the outset. They had great chemistry early on, both offensively and defensively, stringing together an impressive 8-0 run to jump on top early. They came on extremely strong as the quarter was winding down, nailing all six of their last field goal attempts to close out the first. In quarter number two, they fought off several attempted rallies and actually pulled further out in front, ending the half up by 8. And Shaq, what do you think about what we saw from Minnesota?
Well, it's the defense that's driven them in this game so far. They were high energy, high intensity, and it was that determination on D that's allowed them to jump out to this lead. Every stop they've made just seemed to pump them up.
Kenny, let's get your opinion on New Orleans.
They need to break it down, and I look at the individual areas that they're struggling, like they're getting pounded. I mean pounded, Ernie, on the boards. That's a hustle stat.
That's all for now. Say goodbye to the folks. Thanks goodbye, for folks. Joining us. Third quarter, just about ready to begin.
We come back to Minnesota now with a striking look at the 10th Avenue Bridge, downtown Minneapolis, off in the distance. We played through the first half. Plenty of basketball, though, left in this one. Setting the floor now for the Pelicans. Down low, it's Randle and Davis. Holiday and Moore filling out the perimeter. And it's Payton in at the point guard position. Here's Holiday, here's Davis, and denied. He sends it right off the glass. Holiday against Wiggins. Outside, Towns. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. And you think about the game of Karl Anthony Towns, the versatility clock. The versatility just leaps out at you.
Well, he's a man of his times, Kevin, when you talk about his game. I mean, that's where the game is now. And that's always been his ambition, to be as complete a player as possible. And at his size, he shoots it deep, he can post you up. And as he gets better as a passer, he's going to be harder to guard.
Shooting one.
You know, Julius Randle is a young power forward, a little undersized for that position, but fairly dependable. Good movement when he gets to the basket, and he knows how to finish inside. Surprised his rookie option wasn't picked up, but he made the best of it in free agency. And, you know, they don't have it right now. I mean, missing their first three shots so far this half, slow start.
It's stolen by Teague. Over Payton, the Timberwolves again can't hit. And for Randle, a free agent this past summer, it seems he never felt truly wanted by the team that drafted him.
Well, you know, he's dealt with injuries early in his career and a lot of trade rumors, which can affect a young player in a negative way. I think he's still shown solid improvement in his first handful of years in the league. And again, you've got to recall and remember how young some of these guys are. Even when they've been in the league 4, 5, 6 years, some of these guys are like 22, 23 years old. And that's still not enough time for them to fully mature as players.
It's stolen by Randle. Now here's Payton. He's still scoreless so far in this one. Outside Holiday. Moore dishes to Davis. Just 5 to shoot. Outside Holiday. Good on the triple. Holiday's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for 3.
And, you know, Holiday has a gorgeous touch from outside. He's a deadly shooter, an absolute laser when you give him space to fire.
Towns against Davis. Okogie. No good from outside. Pelicans trail by 4. Holiday finds Davis. It's good, the assist that time from Holiday. Holiday's got 3 assists tonight.
And, you know, got to admire the patience inside from Davis. Outstanding at staying under control, taking his time, and burying the quality shot.
So the Timberwolves call their first timeout. New Orleans making some changes here. Miritich is checked in for Randle. Solomon Hill comes in for Etuan Moore. And Ian Clark subbed in for Drew Holiday. Šarić against Miritich. Knocked loose. Here's Davis. He nails it. And we're tied up. Davis has got his 3rd bucket of the night.
Well, that's one way he can finish, but far from the only way he gets it done. He's got all kinds of tricks up his sleeve. And 2 for 1, that's what they'd like to get right now.
That would be ideal, and that's exactly what they'll try to do. They don't need to rush it, just need to get a quality shot, and quickly.
And not quite as aggressive from outside as they were in the first half, sticking to the high percentage shots, playing smart with the lead.
And it's Towns missing, and it's the Pelicans' ball. It's a 12-2 run here, good pace. Davis can't get that one to fall.
Unfortunately, his shot has been everywhere, all over the place. Can't buy a basket. However, his teammates got him covered.
Jones against Payton. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Davis. That is his first foul of the game. Deep, and no luck with that time on the buzzer beater. 3 quarters of play in a close game here. Pelicans lead by 2. And time to step aside quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the fourth quarter. Now let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
Yeah, a terrific, unselfish play right here. Set up his teammate, and how about the setup this was?
Yeah, and as a two guard, he's typically not a reluctant shooter, so it was really nice to see him orchestrating for a teammate instead.
And with three quarters behind us, we start the fourth quarter in what is still anybody's ballgame. Derrick Rose is out there with Jones. Then it's Jared Bayless. Then there's Šarić, and it's Jang in at the center position. So that's the Timberwolves five. The shot misses. Great D that time from Davis. Here's Clark. He's covered by Rose. Floats it up for Davis and finished off by Davis.
And how about the incredible timing on that alley-oop?
He absolutely hammered it down.
Boy, I tell you what, that's the play we'll remember if they can put together a little surge to break this game open.
Here's Jones, following the basket by Anthony Davis. And Elfrid Payton with the foul. That's his first foul. Taj Gibson's checked in for the Timberwolves. Wiggins comes in for Jared Bayless. And New Orleans also making a change. Etwan Moore is checked in for Ian Clark. To the paint. That one's good. The New Orleans lead is cut down to two on the bucket from Andrew Wiggins.
And obviously a total team player. Šarić is a guy, if his teammate is open, he's going to get the ball.
Outside Mirotić. Over Šarić. Another one falls for New Orleans.
That shot was made possible by the work of Anthony Davis.
And it's Jones with the ball for the Timberwolves. Šarić looking around. It's rebounded by New Orleans. Davis has got six rebounds in the game. Moore passes to Payton. Outside, Davis. Six to shoot. And Payton gets it to go on the assist by Davis. And the Pelicans lead by six.
Boy, I think the post game of Payton catches defenders off guard. I mean, he's got a lot of moves down there.
And the Timberwolves call time here. Anthony Davis really making a difference here.
I mean, he's getting to the rack all game, and if they can't do a better job of keeping him out of the paint, they're in for a long night.
So for the Pelicans, Julius Randle comes in for Mirotić, and it's Drew Holiday in for Miller. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Hey, Kevin. Well, during the break, I heard Tom Thibodeau as he talked with the team. Three-pointers have hurt them tonight, and he told his players, we've got to play them better on the three-point line. We can't give them any more clean looks. Kevin?
Thank you, David.
Unselfish, good vision, nice dime by Julius.
Here's Towns. That one a little long. If they want to, they can milk the clock just a little bit here.
Yeah, that's the best option.
The shot by Holiday, no good. Timberwolves trail by eight. Here's Teague. Here's Gibson. The Timberwolves again can't hit. Payton kicks to Holiday. Here's Davis. Off target there, that would have pushed the lead to double digits. There's Towns, and he banks in the layup.
Yeah, you know, the energy, the hustle, the length and reach, Towns using it all to perfection when he attacks the offensive glass.
Now a timeout called by New Orleans. They're in front by 6. 1:10 left in the fourth quarter. The presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, Anthony Davis.
And he's put on a terrific show of skill in the paint. A combination of moves, footwork, and that soft touch down low. It's all added up to one dominant performance for the big fella.
And the call will be against Jeff Teague. That's his first foul. Holiday dishes to Davis, and they double up Davis. Towns with the steal.
Not completely over, but it's getting close.
Yeah, this one is ready to be put on ice. Not a whole lot they can do from here. Absolutely amazing, Kevin. This young man is so money, and his teammates absolutely love him. Karl Anthony Towns, a.k.a. Big Cat.
Chemistry at its best. An unreal alley-oop.
Yeah, you're right. The pass, the catch, the dunk. All of it perfect.
And it all had to be, Kevin, because that's not nearly as easy as they made it appear.
And an intentional foul right there. The first, and that makes it a 7-point lead.
He's only listed at 6'4", but Holiday plays bigger than that. That's the case on D more than anywhere else. He can guard three positions, and there's a lot of value in that.
And so he drops them both. It's an 8-point game. And so it's Minnesota with it.
And really nothing they can do now. They just got to play this one out.
Yep, this one's a wrap, partner.
And the Timberwolves call time here. They're trailing by 8. 29 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Here's Wiggins. Oh, and that one had the right spin on it, and it is good.
Slain and Lane, all comers. Wiggins with the confidence to put the team on his back when it matters most.
So the first one drops, and that makes it a 7-point lead.
Elfrid Payton is known primarily for his playmaking ability. The way he moves the ball is exactly what you want from your point guard.
So he goes 2 for 2 at the line, and it's an 8-point game. And here are the Timberwolves. T kicks to Towns. Back to Teague. Okogie. No good on the three. Holiday looking for an opening. So New Orleans wins it. A solid win on the road for them. This building was dead silent by the time GA this one wound down.
And that's what you want to do. Take the crowd out of it by crunch time. Don't give them any chance to lift their team up at the finish.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks, Kevin. Anthony, tell us the focus for the team coming into the game tonight.
Well, you know, before we started the game, you know, Coach came in and told us that we knew what we had to do. You know, we were trying to stop a lot of the actions, and, you know, our biggest focus for the game was guard the ball. That's what we did, coming out of that timeout and never looked back.
And it led to a win. Thank you for your time, Anthony. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for being with us. So long.